is about Katie's ski tracks and that charity. So yeah, so Katie's ski tracks is a charity that takes 20 children around the UK to Italy skiing. I went on the trip last year. This time last year we got back, I think, yeah. It was a crazy experience. I've never experienced anything like it. So yeah, we go skiing in the Italian Alps, and Katie's has a huge background. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about that first. So Martin, he's up there in the VIP area. Martin and a girl called Katie made what was then called Ski Across, and so Martin's lived a pretty full life. He's got an MBA, and yeah, he's done a lot, and one of his things was to create Katie's ski tracks. So on the third trip, Katie unfortunately died from cancer, was it? Yeah. So Katie died from cancer, and Martin was like, no, I can't do it anymore, I can't do it without Katie. But the lovely Michelle up there, everybody say hi to Michelle up there. So Michelle egged on Martin, and she was like, yeah, come on, we can do this, we'll do it for Katie instead. And then it was called Katie's Ski Tracks. So it's been running for 25 years now, the one that I went on was its 25th. So it's not just a trip, and I said it about the last one, it's not just a trip. There's a huge background, and one of the kids a few years ago actually named a star after Katie's. So up there somewhere, there is a star called Katie Ski Tracks, and the motto is reach for the stars, and we definitely did that on that week. So yeah, it's not just skiing. I think we spent 25% of the time skiing. The rest was partying. We partied hard. So one night we had a party in an igloo. there's some crazy quiz nights and stuff, and everybody's mental, and they literally, they don't treat you like you've got an illness, and they do it with destination very detail. You go on that trip as a child with nothing, with just a one for fun. Because before, like, the trips and things, it's all hospitals, and sometimes kids can spend like years in hospital, and it's easy to just go, hi, my name's Paige, I have blah blah, and hi, my name's whatever, I have this, and it's easy to kind of identify yourself with your condition. So you go on the trip and they don't just go, oh, you're Paige with that condition. They go, oh, you're Paige, come on, let's have some fun. So my experience with Katie's was crazy. I loved every minute of it. We spent 42 hours or something on a coach, literally. Crazy amount of time. But, you know, the help has just made it so fun. I mean, I got on the coach at 3 o'clock in the morning, and the first thing they did when you set off was start dancing with the coach. You're like, oh, we're having a rave at 3 o'clock in the morning. Okay, that's normal. So I'm gonna show you another video, and this was at the end of the night, and this was a speech that I did. Well, you know the speech. But this is something that I said about the trip, and you can see how much it has affected us all, because we were all crying our eyes out, because it meant so much to us.
I want to take us all back to when we first came here, and we went to the church, and I found it really heartwarming when I heard Katie's story. And Michelle and Martin's story. And I feel like even though I've never met Katie, I know her from the trip. And I'm so sorry that she died. But I'm so happy that you helped Martin make this possible. And then God given a candle. And I got forced to think of my past and think of how I've nearly died. And it's been so hard. And when I blew out that candle, I felt like I could move on. So thank you, because I can feel like I can have my future. Because of you, and because of everyone here. So again, thank you, teacher.
Meningitis when she's little, and she has no arms or legs, and she's the bubbliest little girl going. She's 12 years old, and she was bouncing around on the floor going, yeah, I'm here, this is where the party starts. And we were like, yeah, go Ellie. But yeah, along with her and a lot of other people, they really inspired me to have a huge operation, because I knew that I had to have a big operation sometime in my life, and I knew that if I didn't do it soon, then it'd just get harder and harder for me. So because of all the kids from all the different trips, and Katie's kind of pushed me to say yes to a huge operation. They took away a third of my intestines. I have a bag on the outside now, and my life is better than ever. I went through it so much. I went through such a tough time and so much pain last year, but I would not be where I am today without these two charities, and I would not be in pain. I wouldn't be in any more pain if that wasn't for them. That doesn't make sense, but you know, you get me. So yeah, again, please give as much as you can, because these charities really do change people's lives more than you probably know. So thank you.